lying in the Antarctic Circle, that is the southern part of the globe. Antarctica is the fifth largest continent. The continent is divided into two regions, known as East and West Antarctica. East Antarctica makes up two-thirds of the continent and is about the size of Australia. West Antarctica, on the other hand, is a series of frozen islands stretching towards the southern tip of South America, forming an extension of the Andes Mountains. Most of Antarctica experiences 6 months of constant daylight in summer and 6 months of darkness in winter. The South Pole is found in Antarctica. If you stand at the South Pole, you are at the southernmost point on Earth. It doesn't matter which way you look, every direction is north. Millions of years ago, Antarctica had a much warmer climate and boasted evergreen forest and a variety of animals. Fossils from this earlier period provide scientists with clues about life before Antarctica became a vast icy shelf. While Antarctica features harsh living conditions, a number of plants and animals have adapted to survive. Well-known animals that live in Antarctica include penguins and seals. The second most numerous mammal in the world after man is the crabeater seal, a typical Antarctic animal. No one lives in Antarctica permanently. There are bases and settlements that look like towns, but they are places where people arrive and stay for anywhere between about 3 and 18 months. There are always people there, at many of them, but the people quickly move on. In 1959, 12 countries with scientists stationed in and around Antarctica signed an agreement that Antarctica shall continue forever to be used exclusively for peaceful purposes. Since then, more than 38 countries have signed what is known as the Antarctic Treaty. During the 1960s and early 1970s, the nuclear reactor installed at McMurdo Station was the first and only to operate on the Antarctic continent. The driest place on Earth is in Antarctic, called Dry Valleys. Dry valleys are unusual part of Antarctica and ice-free part of Antarctica. Thanks to its dry climate and absence of light pollution, Antarctica is one of the best places on Earth to observe space. In recent decades, scientists use radar and satellite technology have discovered a system of rivers and lakes beneath Antarctica's thick ice sheets. Scientists in Antarctica generally live on a base or a station where everything is provided for them. Antarctica is important for science because of its profound effect on the Earth's climate and ocean systems, which is why so many scientists brave the cold to work there.